Dear viewers, in the previous YouTube video, Google Classroom name of the video, this is the URL, discussed about how to create a new class in the Google Classroom, how to include a post, how to include an announcement. These are all the two topics we have discussed. In this video, the demonstration is going to be illustrated to set the questions or quizzes for the formative assessment. So setting the quizzes in the Google Classroom, it has two different ways to set the quizzes. Number one is using quizzes option within the Google Classroom. Number two is using Google Forms. Let us see what's the difference between these two. If we set the quizzes option for the formative assessment question creation, then there is no auto evaluation for the MCQ types or true or false. But if you use Google Forms, there is a feature for enabling the answer keys, then automatically Google Forms does the auto evaluation. Part of the work will be carried out automatically. Teacher has to evaluate only the open-ended questions or short answer type questions. All the MCQ type questions will be done by Google Classroom automatically. So the best method for assessment is always to use Google Forms. In this video, we are going to discuss about the demonstrations for the Google Form creation. Keep watching and subscribe the channel for notification. Thank you for watching. Open the Google Classroom. It's getting loaded. Now there are three classes already it has been created. Now let us take for example CSE A section class. So here if you notice the left extreme bottom, you will have four features: what is new and send feedback, ask a questions. This question type will enable to participate your students in the forum discussion. So this let us see in the next time. Now let us move on to the CSE class. If you click these three buttons, you will notice move, edit, archive. This is to moving the entire class to the drive. Then move will allow to arrange all the classes. Archive will allow to archive the entire class into the Google Drive. Then your students cannot view this class. It is only for the teacher's archival. Edit is used for editing the class. If you want to change the name of the class, instead CSE data structure or instead CSE electronics and communication engineering, anything you can do and edit. This is to edit the name of the class after creating the class once. Suppose if you want to set a quizzes, or again you want to create a post, or again you want to create an announcement or assessment, you have to click this, the top link. Then the entire class will get loaded. Streaming is to see the entire content part streaming. Now right now the option streaming is enabled to view the user interface. Students, this is the user interface. Here you can set the actions and invite students and a class code. Here this code we have to notify. Based on this you can display, copy or reset or disable. This is the course code. It's useful for announcing to the students. It's useful for displaying in the announcement or any further references. This is the Google unique code created for every courses. Now if you click about option, then here Google Class Drive folder you can bring here, and classroom calendar and Google Calendar. Here there is a special feature here, invite teachers. More than one teacher can collaborate to create a content for the single class. Then add class materials. This is the place you can include class materials. Let us take for example, select files from the desktop. GC is the name of the file I would like to select. GC is about Google Classroom. desktop, GC, open. Now upload. Here we can create classroom content. These all will get archived. There are three ways: upload the file and upload from the drives and upload from the YouTube, upload from other internet resources. Then post. So now one of the material is created for this particular class. If you want to add some more material, then you can keep using add class material. Now let us go back to the streaming. About is the option useful for inviting the teachers for the collaboration for the single class. Multiple teachers can moderate on, can create a content, can work together. And add class material is another powerful feature to include materials for your class, for this particular class data structure CACA section. Now let us go back to the stream. Now here, plus option again. In the last session we discussed create announcement, create assignment. Now we are going to look at the feature named as create question. So it allows to set question. What is the usefulness of Google Classroom? It will allow. Next, either you can treat that question as a short answer type or multiple choice type. If you enable multiple choice type, then all the options you can enable and it will get enabled all the options and you can type your options. Right now, I'm going to set as a short answer. For this short answer, we can upload some material from the hard disk. And you can upload some material from the Google Drive. You can upload some material from the YouTube. You can upload some URLs or references so that here this portion, the content will get loaded. Student will start reading the same material. Let me upload once again. Upload. Select files from the desktop. Now this I am selecting. Upload. Now look at the efficiency of this option. Here the material will go and be seated. And next option, here you can create a question. Explain or write the different features of Google Classroom. Now the question is over. Now the instruction is, please refer attached material for reading activity. Then reading activity. After reading the attached file, answer for this question. So this is the instruction we are giving. It's optional. Due date, you can set the date. What date they want to start and what is the topic related to? Already we have created some list of topics, data types, linear data structures, linked list, tags, queues. So which topic this exercise or this activity associated? Then here, once if we set all these features, this material is optional, but once if we set all these features, here you will look at this ask. You can delete even if you don't want this question, you can delete even ask. Here, ask, immediately it will start getting posted. Schedule, you can schedule the date when you want to give the notification. Suppose you are scheduling this for June month 2018. Right now we are in the month May month. So you can schedule. By the time, automatically Google Classroom will send a notification to your students. Save draft. Suppose you don't want to publish this question right now. You wanted to do some other modifications later. You want to do it. Then you can put it in the save draft. It is up to your choice. Let me use asking. Then automatically it started loading into this sheet. Now this is one type. What is a drawback? Let us see the drawback of this method by setting the multiple choice question. Let us see. What are all the features available in Google Classroom? Now I am choosing the option multiple choice. Option 1, content management system add option. For the second option, learning management system, then add option, assessment, add option, gamification. So here the features right answer, it is not possible to set here. Content management system, learning management system, assessment. These three features are available with the Google Classroom. Gamification is not available. Suppose if we want to set the answer for the auto evaluation, right now it is not possible. Ask. Over. Now there are two different type of questions as for this Google Classroom. What are the features available in Google Classroom? And what write the different features of Google Classroom. One is short answer type. Here no topic is chosen. So let us edit this. Use the double click. Then move to the question. Then use this option to edit the question. So here you can include the topic, linear data structure, whatever the topic you have decided. Say. That's all. Any moment we can go back and edit the questions. Now, the topic of this question, related topic of this question also included. Here, related topic of the question is also included. Here, the related topic of this material is also, announcement is also included. Now, this is the limitation with the quizzes. Whatever we create questions or short answer type or MCQ type, teacher has to evaluate. There is no possibility to set the answer keys and there is no auto evaluation does by the Google Classroom. So we have to move to the Google form to enable the answer key setting and for the auto evaluation. Click this 9 grid button, Google Apps. Click the option Drive. Now click the option New. Here click the option More. Then you will notice these are all the features. We are going to select the option Google Forms, blank form. Yes, now it's loaded. Now first you can create a title for this form. Formative assessment for the Google Classroom. Here you can edit the name of the Google form. This is name of the form, that is file or form name, the holistic form name. This is title of the form. It could be the same or different. Choice is yours. File description. This email address we have to give automatically enabled in the settings to enable every form, submit button and email address. Form description. This form is used to assess the understanding of Google Classroom. Some description. Then first question created. Now this email address, the participant or respondent have to mandatorily fill up this. So now the first question, will Google Classroom allows to upload the contents from the Google Drive? This is a question. Now option one is true. Add other option. Option two is false. Now the multiple choice question already enabled. here you can look at this question can be asked as a short answer type or paragraph type or multiple choice type or check boxes. If that question has more than one right answer, then we may have to use check boxes. The answer is to be from the list box, drop down box, having multiple options or file upload. For the same question, student can write assignment and they can upload. Linear scale is for survey, rating the scale. Multiple choice grid is for multiple choice option. And tick box grid is for tick box option. These are all the options available. Right now, the choice of this question is multiple choice. Even here, instead, along with the text, you are permitted to upload any images also, supportive image. Based on the image also, you can ask question. Our students can refer the image and they can ask the answer for this question. So now, first question type is over. Now, record field we have to enable. Otherwise, students may skip. So to avoid that, every question mandatorily, if you are expecting to answer by the student, then we may have to enable this record button. Then once if the record button is enabled, the star marks will appear for each and every question. Then it will not allow to submit if the student does not answer to this question. Now, let us see how to include the second question. This you have to click add question. Press this. Now second question have come. So here this TT option can be used as a title to include for the second question, or just delete and click. It is not a title, only the question. Now you can create a second question. Can you write the set of features explored in Google Classroom? Set of features that you have explored in Google Classroom. So this question needs explanation. It can be set as a short answer type or paragraph type. If the number of words are limited to 2 to 3 lines, sentences, then you may prefer short answer. If the expected words are more, then paragraph, then long answer text. Students can answer here long answer required. Now let us look at how to set the answer. For this question, true is the answer. Here some unnecessary things have come, we have to delete. So now the first question is true or false. This also we can delete. Then this add option is not a problem. Option 3 enable, delete. These are all the way we can use the decoration of the form. The very first question is used for multiple choice, true or false. Second question is of the type long answer text. Now let us see how to set the right answers for this. Now scroll the form to the top. Use this settings option. This option settings. Click this. You will notice these three options: general, presentation, quizzes. Let us click this quizzes. Limit to one response. Only one time students can respond to these questions. If you click this, only one response. Quizzes. Now, look at everything is disabled. Enable this button. Now, correct answers. Point values, missed question. For every question, you can give the points, 10 points, 20 points, something like that. Correct answer. This is to be mandatorily enabled to set the answer key. Once if these options are enabled, use the save button to save. Now, if you come here, naturally you will notice answer key. Click this answer key. Here, you can choose the right answer. This is viewed by only the teacher. So you can set the right answer for this question. This is of the type paragraph. I can't set the right answer. All the short answers, paragraph, file upload have to be evaluated by the teacher. No auto evaluation is possible. Only for the multiple choice question is possible by the Google Classroom. Now, the 15 points are default points set for this question. I can change 20 points. So now this is over. Now we may have to go back to the questions. Now, if you want to add the third question. Where the cursor is available. Earlier, here the cursor was available. The moment add question is pressed, the question automatically creates below to that the previous cursor. So we have to decide where that question is to be created. Now, list the what is the feature not available? What is the feature not available with the Google Classroom? Number one, content management. Add another. Learning management. Odd option. Assessment. Add option. Gamification. So these are all the four options set for this question. Which is the right answer we have to set? Google Classroom does not provide the feature named as gamification. No gamification, no immersion, no visuals. So it's useful for content management. It's useful for learning management. It's useful for assessment. Any question? Content management. Now answer key is also set. Required. Click the feature required. So here for this question, answer key is set. The points does not change here. The default points, 15 points, I'm using it. That's all. So these are all the options. You can keep on adding all the features. This is to add the section. This is to add video. This is to add image. This is to add titles and descriptions. So this is to add new question. These are all the five powerful features we may have to use during the Google Form creation to set the questions. Now let us treat it as a miniature form. Now how to move to the next step. Now how I can use this form to communicate with my students or to my collaborators? Use the option send. This is the option for color palette, changing the color, something like that. Now press the button send. Now I can type the mail ID of the concerned person to whom I want to send this form, or I can share with the Google Plus, or I can share with the Facebook, or I can share with the formative Twitter, or I can get. Now formative assessment to this all decide what is the subject name, then click this option. Link of this form will get generated automatically. This is the longest URL. If you want to get a shortened URL, click this option. Enable this square box shortened URL. You will get this URL for this form. Just copy, use this option or keyboard option. Copy the URL. Close this form, send form. Now come back to the Google Classroom. Create an announcement or assignment, anything, the type of activity what you would like to conduct. Either you can create an assignment or announcement. Now let me use the topic announcement. Share with your class. This is the URL. You can paste it and you post it. This is one method. Another method, create an assignment. Title. Here you can use the link, add link. This link automatically will help to, this is for assessment. Announcement you can give. Dear students, please participate with your answers. With your answers. Enough. Assign. Again, schedule assign, save date. Assigning. Over. Now, look at this. One is of the form assessment, announcement. One is of the form assignment. Even with the assignment, it is possible to give this link. Copy paste the link, add link, can create title and announcement. Even with the announcement, you can give this link, add link. Respond to the formative assessment. You can include what you want to share with your students, post. Now all the possible ways of announcing this form we discussed. Let us keep watching for the part 2 Google Classroom features. Thanks for